I should like to help everyone if possible. Jew, Gentile, black man, white. We all want to help one another. Human beings are like that. We want to live by each other's happiness, not by each other's misery.
Did you know that 1 in 3 young people end up in a toxic relationship? Now you may ask, what is a toxic relationship? Here are some traits that toxic or unhealthy relationships consist of. Physical and verbal abuse. When your partner is constantly controlling what you're doing and manipulates you to tell them everything you do. Restarting the relationship is another sign because you're forcing it and love shouldn't be forced. Dishonesty in a relationship harms it. You and your partner should be able to trust one another and communicate. Being codependent. You should never rely on your partner too much to the point where you can live without each other. You should be your own person. If you ever find yourself in this position, the best thing you should do is get yourself out of it in a safe way. Talk to your family or a friend if you feel comfortable, and if you wish to stay anonymous, you can always get help at relationshipslife.org.
Okay, is the camera? Oh, okay. Put the camera over here. Okay, yeah, okay.
Confucius once said, "Our greatest glory is not in never failing, but rising every time we fall." This inspires me whenever I feel like I'm at a low, especially when it comes to my art, my education, or even in real life. And that's because I feel like as humans, we always experience a low point in our lives, and it just feels like we're never going to feel like our best selves again. But when we're at that low point, there's always the greatest room to improve and just become a better version of ourselves.
Did the camera die? Please tell me you got that. I need this for a grade.
Coffee. I love coffee. I've always thought of myself as the coffee and my body as the mug. Think about it. The mug is solid and fragile, just like our bodies. But the coffee's amazing. It's stimulating. Coffee makes me feel energized and jittery. But at times, it makes me feel drowsy and anxious. Just like our spirits. I don't think we are our bodies. Our bodies don't define us. I think we are more than our bodies, more than our thoughts, more than our ego. I believe we are cosmic conscious beings that created this reality to experience ourselves with these vessels that we call bodies. We are able to comprehend emotions, pain, urges, thoughts, love, a simple reality. But outside of that, we could be much more. That is only what we as humans are able to understand. But maybe it's more than that. Maybe when we spill out of our mugs, we are able to escape this reality. Maybe we are all just one conscious being. All of our consciousness are nested together like a spider web. And when we meet another human being, it's just ourselves in another lifetime, another reincarnation. We are every human that ever lived. We are the kettle. We just pour a little bit of our soul into a mug, the vessel, to experience life. God, I need to slow down on the coffee.
Seniors, graduation is getting close. Make sure you check your email for scholarship opportunities from your counselor. And stay focused on your classes to avoid any LOC. For LOC information, follow Ms. Avila on Twitter at bavila_ahs.
Don't drink and drive.
Follow us on Twitter @AmericasBAN for sneak peeks and updates. And subscribe to our YouTube channel.